Hey everybody, this is John Lemesny, and tonight I'm going to experiment with the GIMP in order to create an image that represents anger. So the way that I'm going to do that is I'm going to draw a plate on a table that has been shattered. So first I'm going to create a shape, then I am going to shatter that shape. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to rename my background to table. I just did that by double clicking on the background layer and naming it. I'm going to add a new layer called plate. And I'm going to make it transparent, meaning that you can see through it. The table I'm going to make a fill of an off-white color, something sort of linen-y. There it is. I'm going to go back to my plate layer, and I'm going to use the ellipse select tool. Holding down control makes it go from center out. Holding down shift makes it constrained, and that's what I want. So I'm going to take my fill tool again now. I'm going to select a bright white, and I'm going to fill that circle with bright white. I'm going to take my selection tool again, and go into the settings to make sure that I am with the selection tool, make sure that I am replacing the current selection as opposed to adding to it. So I'm going to now hold down shift again. Move this to the visual center of that plate. I'm going to go back to my fill tool, and this is all in the same plate layer. I'm going to go back to my fill tool and choose a slightly darker center of the plate. That's actually a little bit too dark. I'm going to go back, choose that color again, a little bit closer to white this time. That's better. So hopefully anybody who looked at that would have the impression that this was a plate, okay? So now I'm going to go into the select menu and choose select none. And there is my plate, which is separate from my table. I can tell that it's separate from my table because if I hide it, the plate goes away. Okay. Now all I have to do is start to create shards and pull them away from the original plate. So I can start to do that by choosing this free select tool. While I have plate selected, I'm just going to make a shard. I'm going to undo that. I'm going to, now that I've made this selection, I'm going to cut the selection, and I'm going to paste it as a new layer. And by pasting it as a new layer, I now have the ability to move it really wherever I want. So I'm going to continue to do that making sure that my plate layer is selected. I'm going to again cut and then edit, paste as new layer. I'm going to